story with Rava, unbelievable story I read yesterday, I want to share with you. There were two friends, Avram Yitzchak came to Avram and said, listen, do me a favor, can you give me 100 gold coins for 6 months? He said, fine, come on, give me tomorrow. He gave him 100 gold coins, 6 months passed. So Avram comes to Yitzchak and says, Yitzchak, give me my gold coins, I gave it to you. So what are you talking about? If you're going to lie, I'm going to go to Rava. He came to Rava. Rava said, Yitzchak, not nice. He gave you 100 gold coins. Give it back to him. He said, Rava, I gave it to you. Mm-hmm. What's the Pasha name? Matot. Every man, older generations, used to work with a staff. Matot, staff. Asol. Every man, remember in Samarkand, Tashkent, Bukhara, all people used to work with Asol. Why today they don't work like this? Oh, many people today, they drive a car. B, those who work with Asol, they might fall, so therefore they work with a walker. That's more safer for them. But olden times, there was no such thing walker, they used to work with Asol. Only men, by the way, no women. For women, it was not serious that they had in Shalom Aleichem. So men used to work with the staff. And today, you should know, staff is a sign of Hashibut. Did you know Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Shvatim, everybody, all the big rabbis, Moshe, Aaron, Yosef, David, everybody had staff. Everybody worked with staff. This is why Hasidus show. What else? You buy so what happened is, what happened is, this is my Hasidish rabbi, they work with the staff. Why? Chashivut. Importance. So what happened? Rabbi came to the guy and said, listen, Yitzchak, give 100 gold coins. He gave 100 gold coins to he said, I gave her. He said, I'm going to take you to Shul, make you pick up Sefer Torah and swear. He says, I'm ready. He said, okay. He said, no, let me go. I forgot my staff at home. So he took staff. Now Avram standing here, the one who gave the money. Rava standing here, Yitzchak standing there. So Rava said, take Sefer Torah. So he says, how will I take Sefer Torah? Hold my staff. So the one, Avram, who gave him the money, says, hold my staff. Hold this staff. And now Yitzchak takes Sefer Torah. Fake! Liar! I swear with Hashem's name, I gave it back to him. Avram standing like this. He says, look at this. Liar! He got so angry, he took the staff, stuck on the floor. He hit on the floor, staff broke, all the 100 gold coins fell down. What happened? He was holding Sefer Torah as if he's saying right, like, because he's holding it. So as if he says, I gave it back, so I gave it back. Mm. But he doesn't know the money's inside. Wow. Trick. He hit it on the floor and the truth came out. Wow. Unbelievable. I read it yesterday night, this Pasha Matot talks about staff. Everybody has staff.
It's a blank check. Bounce check.
Oh yeah.
Bounce check.
Of course. My father said to me a story about Avrom et Kalam. Remember Avrom et Kalam? Do you remember the story? Yimach Shemam veZichram, Russian government, Lenin, Stalin, right? Lenin was that time. They came, they took all his house away from him. And they made his house into a museum because that was the most beautiful house in Samarkand. He was the richest man in the town. They made him poor. So afterwards, he was sitting calmly. I think the only thing they didn't find him was his staff. That they didn't take from him. They said, listen, you old man, hold it. That's the only thing he gave to his children.
All
those inside. That's the only thing he gave to his children. But what happened? When one day he came to his house, to see his own house, the security guard standing there, did you buy a ticket to see the museum? He started crying. He said, to go to see my house, I have to buy a ticket? He started crying. This was the garment of Russia. 50, 60, 70, 80 years ago. Yimach Shemam. Now, I would like to share a story with you, but I wanted to say something I forgot. There's something with my father incident. Today, when somebody swears today, does it work or no? Listen to the story happened when my father was there. 1967, somebody got caught by a government. And they gave him 10 years to be in jail. They said, tomorrow morning, police will come to your house and take you to jail. He ran home, and he takes all his whatever left from his grandfather, and he gave it to his neighbor. He said, listen, tomorrow police coming to take me. I want you to hold it for 10 years. Can you give it back to me as a true neighbor? He said, I promise you, I'm going to give it back to you in 10 years. That was his generation. So what happened? After 10 years, he came out from jail. He goes to his neighbor's house. He said, I'm sorry, I'm on the journey. Why'd you come? He said, listen, we made a deal with you. When we deal with you, that you took from me, you're going to give it back to me after 10 years. He said, never happened, what's up? He said, listen, that's the only thing I have. I have kids to marry. I'm going to take you to shul. That was in Samarkand. My father was that day in shul. 1967, it happened. 1977, my father was in shul. 10 years later. So the guy comes in and says, I'm going to pick up Sefer Torah and swear that I didn't take from you nothing. He picks up the Sefer Torah and he swears. He says, whoever took did not return, he should become blind. In the morning, the guy woke up and became blind. So today, this swear work or no? We don't have Ben HaMikdash.
Yes, the word.
We don't have such a Sunday kingdom we had thousands of years ago. Huh?
It works.
We should have done it, though.
Chida, this week's Pasha says, וכל אשר היוצא מפיו יעשה. Means, anything came out from your mouth, you should keep. Chida says, nah, it's, you're right, it's a simple answer, it's a deeper answer. וכל אשר היוצא מפיו, anything comes out from your mouth, in here, יעשה, it does actions in Shamayim. וכל אשר יוצא מפיו יעשה. Whatever comes out from your mouth, it does actions in Shamayim. So therefore, some people, God forbid, as a joke, they say, if like this, I would shoot myself. Yeah. Then you hear the incidents. Here, there, Florida, China, here. Why? When you say something, Satan says, amen. Therefore, say good stuff. Good stuff. Bless. Bless yourself, bless others. Be positive. Be good. Be always talk positive. Always talk good. That's the only thing will make the world and you in good place. And that's very important. I want to start with you today. Zera Shimshon, Parashat, Mas'ei. But before this, I would like to announce Hashem Shalom.
Hi. Michael.
Rav Michael. He's come on, I think. Ani, they have 11 brothers and sisters and they live in Tzfat.
Okay.
They live in Tzfat. Kama shani kwa?
Kama shani? Mada gidiz. Aya isa shani mada kwa?
His father was 10 years on a bed and 5 years ago he passed away. So he saw me last week in Yeshua. He said, can I come to your shul? I want to announce my situation if anyone can help me with something. Of course, we didn't come for this, we came for Shiva, that's for sure. But anyone wants to help him with something, in 2 hours, he's going back to Israel. He's going to come back in a month. In a month and a half, he's going to be back. But if anyone wants to give him... Okay, he's a good Chazan. I will ask him. It's still recording, right? Yeah, let it be. Shalaya was alive, you know. I would ask you to say a few nice songs, okay? And after this, anyone wants to give him something, I don't want to keep him here because I don't want him to be late for his plane, okay? So anyone wants to give him something, please give him, okay? בכבוד כבודו.
כל ישראל יש להם חלק לעולם הבא, שנאמר מכולם צדיקים לעולם ישוע ארץ נצא ותאי מעשה די להתפעל והם מדליקים ובמים מדליקים מדליקים לא בלחש ולא בחוסן ולא מחלך ולא בפתילת העידן. זה בעצם בערב שבת. יש איזה שיר ספציפי שאתם אוהבים? או שרק מעוול וזהו?
מה שכבודו רוצה?
אלי לי אלי 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 חביבי שמע ישראל אדוני אלוהינו אדוני אחד. אתם עונים בחזרה.
שמה ישראל
אדוני מלך אדוני מלך אדוני לעולם חיים
אדוני מלך אדוני מלך אדוני לעולם חיים
אדוני מלך אדוני מלך אדוני מלך לעולם ועד
אדוני מלך אדוני מלך אדוני מלך לעולם ועד
אדוני הושיענא אדוני הושיענא
תזכו בעזרת השם כשם ששימחתם יתומים, שהקדוש ברוך הוא ישמח את הילדים שלכם, את המשפחות שלכם בחזרה. נזכה בעזרת השם של שפע גדול, להצלחה, יראת שמיים, לתורה בעזרת השם, שנזכה להגיע לחודש אלול, מוכנים ומזומנים בעזרת השם. חיים טובים מול שלום.
אמן.
תמשיך להפיץ את אור התורה, שבח. זכיתם, ברוך השם. שם כוח גדול צדיקים, שם שורות לכולם. שם כוח צדיקים. תודה רבה. שם כוח צדיקים.